Amulet of Mara. I am sworn to carry your burdens. Let's go.
Keep an eye out for wolves if you're headed up the path to High Hrothgar.
I did. Strange days when the monks will do that. I wonder what it means. I like to spend time up here. Walk the steps. Meditate on the emblems. Doesn't hurt when I bag some game along the way. They're not the sort to take visitors, but I never go that high up the path anyway. Some folk who make the trip leave them food or other essentials, but not to make conversation. Until next time.
I was just outside Ivarstead when it happened. It's an exciting moment. Nothing like this has happened in centuries. Just a pilgrim. I'd prefer to leave it at that, if you don't mind. Walking the steps, meditating on the emblems. I make this trip every few years. Until next time.
Dragonborn appears at this moment in the turning of the age. First, let us see if you truly are Dragonborn. Let us taste of your voice. Dragonborn, it is you. Welcome to High Hrothgar. I am Master Arngeir. I speak for the Greybeards. Now, tell me, Dragonborn. Why have you come here? We are the Greybeards, followers of the Way of the Voice. You stand in High Hrothgar, the slopes of Kinnereth's sacred mountain. Here we commune with the voice of the sky and strive to achieve balance between our inner and outer selves. We are here to guide you in that pursuit, just as the Greybeards have sought to guide those of the dragon blood that came before you. You are not the first. There have been many of the dragon blood since Akatosh first bestowed that gift upon mortal kind. Whether you are the only dragonborn of this age, that is not ours to know. You are the only one that has been revealed thus far. That is all I can say. You have shown that you are Dragonborn. You have the inborn gift. But do you have the discipline and temperament to follow the path laid out for you? That remains to be seen. Without training, you have already taken the first steps towards projecting your voice into a thoom, a shout. Now let us see if you are willing and able to learn. When you shout, you speak in the language of dragons. Thus, your dragon blood gives you an inborn ability to learn words of power. All shouts are made up of three words of power. As you master each word, your shout will become progressively stronger. Master Einarth will now teach you Dro, the second word in Unrelenting Force. Dro means balance in the dragon tongue. Combine it with Fus, force, to focus your thumb more sharply. Dro. Absorb a slain dragon's life force and knowledge directly. As part of your initiation, Master Einarth will allow you to tap into his understanding of Rome. Impressive. Your thought. Boom is precise. You show great promise, Dragonborn. We will perform your next trial in the courtyard. Follow Master Boy. Master Bori will teach you Wuld, which means whirlwind.
Wuld!
You must hear the word within yourself before you can project it into a thing. Approach Master Bori and he will gift you his knowledge of Wuld. Master Wulfgar will demonstrate Whirlwind Sprint. Then it will be your turn. Master Bori.
Max!
Wulf! Now, your turn. Stand next to me. Master Bori will open the gate. Use your whirlwind sprint to pass through before it closes. Quick mastery of a new Thum is astonishing. I'd heard the stories of the abilities of Dragonborn, but to see it for myself. You were given this gift by the gods for a reason. It is up to you to determine how best to use it. You are now ready for your last trial. Retrieve the horn of Jörgen Windcaller, our founder, from his tomb in the ancient fane of Ostengrav. Remain true to the way of the voice, and you will return. No doubt, the appearance of a dragonborn of this time is not an accident. Your destiny is surely bound up with the return of the dragons. You should focus on honing your voice. And soon your path will be made clear. There is indeed much that we know that you do not. That does not mean that you are ready to understand it. Do not let your easy mastery of the voice tempt you into the arrogance of power. That has been the downfall of many Dragonborn before you. No doubt. The appearance of a dragonborn. You should focus on honing your voice. Dragons have the inborn ability to learn and project their voice. Dragons also are able to absorb the power of their slain brethren. A few mortals are born with similar abilities, whether a gift or a curse has been a matter of debate down through the centuries. What you have already learned in a few days took even the most gifted of us years to achieve. Some believe that Dragonborn are sent into the world by the gods at times of great need. We will speak more of that later, when you are ready. Dragons have always been able to shout. Language is intrinsic to their very being. There is no difference in the dragon tongue between debating and fighting. Shouting comes as naturally to a dragon as breathing or speaking. In mythic times, when mortal kind was in great need, the goddess Kinnereth granted us the ability to speak as dragons do. For most people, long years of training are required to learn even the simplest shout. But for you, the dragon speech is in your blood, and you learn it almost without effort. Dragons have... There is no... In mythic, for most people, but for you, the dragon speak...
Five. Our leader, Partanax, lives alone on the peak of the throat of the world. When your voice can open the path, you will know you are ready to speak to him.
As I said, you will know you are ready when your voice can open the path to him. We study the way of the voice according to the teachings of our founder, Jürgen Windcore. Very few are permitted to study with us here at High Hrothgar. But in your case, Dragonborn, it is a privilege to guide you towards mastery of your voice.
Their voices are too powerful for anyone not trained in the way to withstand. Even a whisper could kill you.
The voice was a gift of the goddess Kinnereth at the dawn of time. She gave mortals the ability to speak as dragons do. Although this gift has often been misused, the only true use of the voice is for the worship and glory of the gods. True mastery of the voice can only be achieved when your inner spirit is in harmony with your outward actions. In the contemplation of the sky, Kinnereth's domain, and the practice of the voice, we strive to achieve this balance.
The Dragonborn is an exception to all the rules. The dragon blood itself is a gift of the gods.
If we accept one gift, how can we deny the other? As Dragonborn, you have received the ability to shout directly from Akatosh. We therefore seek to guide you on the proper use of your gift, which transcends the restrictions which bind other mortals. We study the way of the voice according to the teaching. Very few are permitted to study with us. But in your case, Dragonborn, it is a privilege to guide you towards mastery of your voice.
You there. You're the one they call Dragonborn. Your lies fall on deaf ears, deceiver. We know you are the false Dragonborn. You shall not stand in the way of the true Dragonborn's return. He comes soon, and we shall offer him your heart. When Lord Mirak appears, all shall bear witness. None shall stand to oppose him.
Thank you. out fighting dragons, and what do I get? God.
Quite a climb, wasn't it? Anyway, much appreciated. Here, take this for your troubles. Thanks again for the legwork.
An amulet of Mara. I'm at your command. Let's go.
I will stay right here and wait for you. Excellent. Now, you must come with me. You become a part of this. You must be present for the ritual. It is time, Mars.
You bring an outsider here, and now insist I call on Malekith for help when he has clearly forsaken me. You try my patience, Atub.
Doing nothing will not grant our tribe relief from this curse. We must try.
Fine. Let's get this over with.
Now we begin the ritual. Great Malekith, we beseech you, aid us in our time of need.
Why are we bothering with this?
You pathetic weakling!
What's that?
Malekith has heard my pleas. He speaks to us.
You dare summon me, Yamars?
What? What is this?
You don't deserve to call yourself an orc. You're weak, you're small, and you're an embarrassment. You let giants, overrun my shrine. Bring me their leader's club as an offering, and I might release you from this curse.
So it will be. Malekith has spoken, Yamars. Your path is clear.
Very well. You, outsider, come here. I want a word. This is all your fault, you know. I'm stuck fighting a giant now, thanks to you. So you're going to help me. You're going with me, and you're going to make sure I don't have any trouble reaching that giant. Don't worry. I'll make it worth your while. This giant, it's not the only thing in the Fallowstone Cave. Getting to it isn't going to be easy. You're going to clear a path to the giant so I can conserve my strength. I'll make sure you're paid for it. So you meet me at Fallowstone Cave, and I'll get this over with. I could have my tribe back and you can leave us alone. Let's just get this over with. Weeks? Longer. Feels like an age has gone by. I haven't slept in so long. Oh, of course. Because Malakath would take pity on us if only a useless outsider would lend us a hand. Fight well. If there's a chance this'll save me, then I'm taking it. I'll lead the way, but you'd better back me up. Let's get this over with. kill this giant. Unless, of course... All right. Unless, of course, you'd like to make some extra gold. Fine. Then wait here. This should only take a second. Never should have come here.
Get ready. Trouble ahead.
All right. I'll go kill this giant. Unless, of course, you'd like to make some extra... Fine. Then wait here. This should only take a second.
Ymaris was a fool, always trying to scheme his way out of responsibility. But you took care of him and the giants. Two problems solved at once. Now, take Shagril's hammer back to Largishburg, and we'll see about whipping the rest of them into shape.
The ways of the mystic are known to me. I have remedies and cures, should you need them. But what of your Mars? I see. He did not survive. He died well. Ah, that is good to hear then.
Ymars was a coward and a weakling. His deceitful ways have cost you all greatly.
So he has been punished. And what of us? What fate shall we suffer?
You'll have to prove yourselves, but I'm willing to give you a chance. Gullerzo's in charge now. Let's hope he's a better chief. You, place that hammer on the shrine. You're the only one who's proven worthy in all of this.
May your weapons be sharp and your prey fresh. It is good to finally know that Malakath has not forsaken us.
I am surprised that Gullerzu was named chief.
Mm-hmm. All right.
I will do my best to lead the tribe, but I don't know why Malakath chose me.